Hello and welcome to all of you for this session wherein we are going to discuss the practical course, the exams which are due in this month end. Organic qualitative analysis, this is one of the major experiment, and out of 80, 40 marks are allotted to this and the remaining experiments are there. Now, as per SPPU guidelines, you are supposed to write down 60% of the experiments. So, there are 20 experiments. So, you are supposed to write 12. Out of 12, 3 organic mixtures and then preparation, volumetric estimations, all those things. So, probably we will put a list of the experiments and you are supposed to write all these things in your journal and keep it ready before the final exam. So, maybe another week you will get for the preparation. And the exams will be from the 31st of May, that is the probable date. Okay. Now, organic qualitative analysis, you must have studied few things in the previous standard, especially the binary mixtures. Now, here also we are going to discuss the binary mixtures. There are three types of mixture or three natures, I will say, solid, solid. Both solids are mixed, the solid dissolved in liquid, and two liquids amongst those two, one will be volatile, the other one will be non-volatile liquid. Now, the first mixture which we are going to discuss is acid phenol, cinnamic acid and beta naphthol. I am just putting the names for the sake of convenience. Then the first thing is you have to find out the type of mixture, whether it is acid base, acid phenol, acid neutral, base phenol, phenol base, phenol neutral, anything it can be. And for solid solid, one of the mixture we are just taking the representative is cinnamic acid, beta naphthol. First of all, how to determine the type? You have to take mixture, a little part of mixture, put 10% bicarbonate solution. And without shaking or stirring, if you get effervescence of CO2, that means acid is there or acid may be present. The reaction is RCOONA. This is water soluble plus H2CO3, which decomposes into H2O and CO2. That is how you get CO2 gas. Now, the formation of CO2 means there is a reaction between acid component and bicarbonate, and you are getting sodium salt of acid, which is water soluble, and carbonic acid decomposes into H2O and CO2. So, that is what we are getting, the CO2 effervescence. That means acid may be present. At this stage, you have to filter the reactor resultant mixture. You will get filtrate and residue, two components. So, to the filtrate, if you add concentrated HCl, you will get precipitate, because when I add HCl to this, once again it will form RCOOH and NaCl. Now, NaCl will obviously go with water, but acid, organic acid is not water soluble. So, this organic acid will come out upon cooling, and this is detection, this is precipitation. Now, once you get precipitate, that means acid is confirmed. This is first thing. Now, second half has to be done with residue and not with mixture. So, residue plus NaOH, the immediate test, bicarbonate, NaOH, 1:1 HCl, and if one is acid, NaOH test, 1:1 HCl test are absent. That means by default it is neutral. So, here residue plus NaOH. Now, since it is single compound, you have to look at the solubility. It will be completely soluble. Phenol may be present. If you add concentrated HCl, once again the phenol will give the phenoxide ion initially. We know that phenols are weakly acidic. So, a strong base can abstract a proton. Now, to get the Now this is salt, so water soluble. If I add HCl to this, we are generating the phenol back. This is precipitate. So phenol is generated. That means a mixture is acid phenol type of a mixture, and then immediately after the determination of type, you have to go for the separation of the two components. Now for separation, for acid phenol, you can't use NaOH because NaOH will react with both, but bicarbonate being a weak base, it preferably reacts with acid and it will not react with phenol. So separation is possible. Now here also you have to take mixture and bicarbonate and filter it off. You will get two component, filtrate and a residue. To the filtrate, if you add HCl, you will get precipitate of acid, and residue is by default phenol because we have already determined it. Now once you have these separated components in your hand, then your job is to go for the individual analysis of the components. So first component is acid. Now for acid, you have to just dry it in front of infrared lamp, and immediately you have to determine the preliminary test elements, physical constant and functional group. So preliminary test, I'll tell. The first test is with bromine water. Now bromine water, the reaction is with aromatic compounds. It gives decolorization with precipitation, that is electrophilic substitution. But for this kind of acid, like what we have written, the cinnamic acid, this is cinnamic acid. Now if I add bromine to this, it is addition across the double bond. So we expect the formation of dibromide here. So this is electrophilic addition across the double bond. If the same test is done with phenol, because we are doing phenol, I am just telling the test with phenol also. With bromine water will give 2,4,6 tribromophenol. Now here decolorization is there with precipitation. That means it is electrophilic substitution on the aromatic ring. Phenols being reactive substrates, electrophilic substitution take place. Here, since conjugation is there, the double bond is there, it is electrophilic addition. So this is decolorization without precipitation, this is decolorization with precipitation. So that is the difference. So with bromine water and KMnO4 can also react with this, and you will get the decolorization, and you will get vesinal diol or glycol here. The next important test is flame test. Now flame test suggests whether the given compound is aliphatic or aromatic. Now since you are working with two aromatic compounds here, we are expected to get sooty flame, the soot like particles, black soot will come out, just like you burn the tire, the rubber, the soot comes out. So flame test will tell you whether the given compound is aromatic or not. The soot formation is possible because it has got higher quantity of carbon. Soon after this, you have to determine the elements. Now elements, the sodium fusion test, the general procedure is you have to take borosil glass test tube, dry test tube, fuse sodium, add your substance, dried substance to it, fuse it once again, and to the same test tube you have to add distilled water, drop oils until the excess sodium is reacted upon and you get the sodium fusion extract or filtrate. Now that extract is used for the detection of nitrogen, sulfur and halogen. For nitrogen, if you recollect, green color or blue color when you are using concentrated HCl and dilute HTSO4. For sulfur, the special reagent is sodium nitroprusside, which gives violet coloration, and for halogen the silver nitrate test. So any halide will give precipitate, provided you are using distilled water, because the tap water contains a lot of chlorine, so it may interfere. And for nitrogen, you have to take that filtrate, add FSO4, then you have to boil it, FSO4, NaOH, and boil it, and then you have to acidify with those two reagents, concentrated HCl or H2SO4, accordingly you will get green or blue coloration. So the principle behind this is how that blue and green color is formed. If nitrogen is present in the compound, it forms sodium cyanide when it is fusing with sodium, and that sodium cyanide interacts with FeSO4 and it forms sodium ferricyanide, that gives the coloration in acidic medium. Sulfur nitroprusside is the only reagent, and here AgNO3 is the only reagent. Physical constant, the melting point you can determine with the Thiele's tube, that is what we are having in our hand. Now functional group test, now this is important. The functional group test for acid, you have got two tests. In your book only one is given, this second test is not there. First is 10% bicarbonate treatment, that is what we are doing for the detection also. Second test is esterification. Esterification is, I will just put acid, benzoic acid for simplification, ethanol, concentrated H2SO4, one drop, and heat. What you get? You get the formation of ester. Now this ester gives fruity smell, so that is esterification test, which gives fruity smell, and that is the another confirmatory test for acid. If it is phenolic acid, then you have to go for the FeCl3 test. If you are working with salicylic acid, you will get violet coloration for the acid. Now moving on to the second component, that is phenol. Now phenol, once again you have to go for the preliminary test, as I have told you earlier. Bromine water gives the decolorization with precipitation. KMnO4 may not interact with this, and the next test is element. Element detection, once again you have to fuse the sodium, then fuse it with phenol, add water cautiously, get a water solution, or that sodium fusion extract, divide it in three part, check it for nitrogen, sulfur and halogen. Now in this case, since we are working with cinnamic acid and phenol, all these tests would be negative, but that is how you are supposed to proceed. Once elements are determined, then the physical constant. And for functional group, in case of phenol, there are so many tests. First one is FeCl3 test. FeCl3 test, I'll just tell you the now this gives color. Now different colors are obtained for different phenols. So alpha naphthol gives green color, beta naphthol light green color. Now here generally green color you remember. Now this I'll come to the next test. Now here faint green color if you get, that means phenolic OH is there, and this is the compound which is giving the color. We'll come to these things also. Okay. The second test is phthalein test. Now phthalein test is your phenol is treated with phthalic anhydride. This is phthalic anhydride and concentrated H2SO4 one drop. Heat, cool, and add to excess of NaOH. So, if this test, now this is phthalein test. Now, phthalein test is characteristic. So, you can determine whether alpha naphthol is there, beta naphthol is there, and the other phenolic compounds also you can find out with it. So, yeah. A red coloration for cresol, orthocresol, if I use in the same way, this is nothing but your benzoylation reaction or aryoylation reaction. So that with different phenolic compound, different color is obtained. So you can use this as a distinguishing test also. For bromine water, we have already said that the precipitation is going to be there, and the precipitation is mainly because of the electrophilic substitution. And with phenol, you are going to get 2,4,6 tribromine phenol. So, similar reaction, the electrophilic substitution would take place. Fourth test is litmus test. Now, litmus test is used when your substance is water soluble or water miscible. In this case, it is not applicable because these compounds are not going to be water soluble. But if it is water soluble component for neutral or acid, then you can use this. Say, for example, oxalic acid, which is water soluble. So, the testing of that is done with litmus test. You have to take moist litmus paper, say blue litmus paper, it will turn red, and so on. And then Lieberman's test. Now, Lieberman test is the test when phenol is treated with sodium nitrite, and in acidic medium, if you heat it, you will get brown coloration, and that brown coloration is because of the formation of nitroso compound. So, nitroso compound is formed, and if you add that to water, you will get red color. If you add it to NaOH, you will get deep blue color. That is the indication of phenolic compound, that is known as Lieberman's test. So, these are all tests which are available. Now, we will move to the second mixture. I will just quickly go to second and third mixture, because the qualitative analysis basics will be same. It will vary according to your mixtures. So, salicylic acid, M-nitroaniline. I am just putting the examples. This is acid base. Salicylic acid base, once again, you can separate them with bicarbonate or NaOH also, because NaOH is not going to interact with nitroaniline. So, separation would be take mixture, put NaOH, stir it, filter it up. Filtrate will contain sodium salt of this salicylic acid. If you acidify, you will get salicylic acid back, and residue would be M-nitroaniline. For salicylic acid, once again, the preliminary test, functional group test. Now, functional group test here, it will be FeCl3 will give violet coloration because it is phenolic acid, and when it goes to M-nitroaniline, the nitrogen would be there in the form of element. And for this very base, you will get two tests. So, M-nitroaniline, I will just put this structure. There are two functional group. One is primary amine, the diazotization test substance, then HCl, add NaNO2, cool it and add this mixture into a solution of beta naphthalene NaOH, and that is the diazotization test. So if it gives orange red color, that is primary amine, yellow color secondary amine, green color tertiary amine, and all those distinguishing test is there. So for primary amine you are going to get orange diced up, so that is there. For NO2 neutral reduction test, FeHCl or zinc HCl, so NO2 group will be reduced and you will get the precipitate for the same. So NO2 group one test neutral reduction, NH2 group another test. For the functional groups, the other things would be same. Now here you have to keep in mind that the aromatic bases are having pungent odor, so handling should be avoided. You have to take it with the help of spoon or paper or something, but not to touch these compounds because they have got fishy smell, very bad odor, and they are not at all pleasant. So you have to handle all these chemicals carefully in the laboratory. Okay. Now one more mixture I'll just tell, that is third one. Paranitroaniline and chloroform. This is solid liquid. This is volatile liquid. So initially, before type determination, separation has to be achieved. Separation is first. Second is type determination for this kind of mixture, because unless you separate them, you cannot go for the type determination. So separation means you have to distill out chloroform using water bath and the conventional distillating unit, distillation unit. So distill out this, and then you will have this as a volatile component and residue which is left in the flask, that is going to be your base. Once again, for this you have to determine the, you have to check whether it is, since it is liquid, you have to check whether it is water miscible or not. Otherwise, if it is water miscible, then you have to go for litmus test. If it is water immiscible, you have to go for the chemical test, that is bicarbonate, NaOH and 1:1 HCl treatment. If nothing is positive, that means the given compound is neutral, and so on. For residue base, you have to go for the like type you can determine. Take this compound and then dissolve it in 1:1 HCl. It is soluble and regenerated with NaOH. That is how the base is detected and precipitated. After that, the conventional preliminary test, action of bromine water, action of KN104, flame test, followed by elements, nitrogen, sulfur, halogen. Here nitrogen would be there because it is going to form the sodium cyanide, which will be reflecting in the form of the ferric cyanide test, the color, and so on. And once again, once the base is there, you have to find out whether it is primary, secondary or tertiary with the help of the very well known diazotization test, and after that the physical constants of both the compounds. For liquid, you have to determine the boiling point, for solid the melting point, and so on. So these are the three mixtures I wanted to tell you. In your notebook also, you are supposed to write three organic and three inorganic qualitative analysis mixtures, and after this the preparations and derivatives, whatever is there in the volumetric estimations, you have to write it. 12 experiments from each you are supposed to write. So lot of work is there, but 1 week is there, so you can take your time and write down these three mixtures. Also you can write down, or you got a video also, I've seen on your group, you can use that also, no problem, but should be ready with you when you face the exam. Okay. That's all I wanted to tell you. All the best for your exam. Thank you.